Welcome to Tigers TV for today's game between the Telford Tigers and the Peterborough Phantoms. Phantoms, who currently sit 8th place in the league, just above Tigers. However, Tigers can go ahead of them if they win here today and away tomorrow at Bracknell. Ahead of tonight's match, we caught up with player coach Tom Watkins to get his thoughts on what lies ahead.
Big game, as they all are, but it's still quite early in the season. It's only November, but to play Peterborough and Bracknell in the same weekend, and I can understand why we kind of feel it's such a big weekend for us. But if it doesn't go our way this evening, there's still a long way to go in the season. I like the look of the team. We've had a great week of practice. We've been on the ice 5 times as a group, so it's given us a good preparation. So hopefully we can make a good start tonight.
We're talking about the additional practices, how much of a difference does that make in terms of helping the team gel, particularly with the new guys coming on board?
I think short term you probably won't see a hell of a lot, but as we move through the end of November, December, and we get guys on the ice more regularly, in terms of us being able to fine tune, set plays, really isolate certain areas of our game that are perhaps a weakness or things that we need to slightly improve, then it will make a big difference to the team. But it's only been the first week of doing it, so although we've spent time doing things, I wouldn't expect to see a huge difference because of that just yet.
And then we've talked about the 3 new guys coming in. Are there any more guys that you're still looking to add? I know there's obviously kind of talk of 1 or 2 players possibly still coming in.
At the minute, to be honest, there's nothing actually on the cards. So let's focus on this weekend before we get ahead, and certainly let's focus on tonight than on tomorrow. So, looking for a good effort from the guys tonight, and we're just looking for a lot of passion and determination from the players tonight.
to the Peterborough Phantoms, scored by Alexander McQueen, Paul Davis, assisted by Kevin Long, Eric Kendrick, and 93, Alex Alceski. We'll be back in 13 minutes for this evening's second period of ice hockey action.
For tonight's game, we caught up with Tigers' recent signings, Teemu Kuhlevainen, Adam Walker and James Spees, to find out how they've been selling into the game. For today's game, we caught up with Tigers' recent signings, Teemu Kuhlevainen, Adam Walker and James Spees, to find out how they've been selling in at the Tigers.
Everything's been good, for me at least, and house and the things, how they fix. The team helps me with the things like bank account and phone and everything, so it's been good. And living with him is living the dream.
Tell us about living the dream
anymore. Yeah, it's a lot less fun than it sounds. No, it's good. It's been good since I came down here, and living with Teemu has been a lot of fun. And we had a little incident with the naan bread last night, but apart from that, it's been a lot of fun.
Yeah, we saw the pictures on Twitter or Facebook, I think, of the I'm not sure naan bread's the right word for that.
I don't think. I know, it's more like a slab.
How about
yourself? Yeah, good. Unfortunately, I don't get to live the dream with these guys, but obviously I come up from Coventry. But yeah, we're settling in okay. Had a good week, couple of weeks of training now. Obviously, last weekend we got a couple of games under our belt. Not the results we wanted, but you know, I think we're coming together and we're ready.
Fantastic. And then just looking ahead to this weekend, guys. Obviously, Peterborough here today, and then away to Bracknell tomorrow. What are your thoughts on the games?
Yeah, I don't know anything about these teams, but I think we had a good week in practice, so I'm sure we'll be okay in the games. And
yeah, I think as long as we come and we work hard and work on the things we did in practice this week, then we should be fine. We should be good to go.
Yeah, you know what? The bottom line is, if we want to move up the league, we need to be beating these teams that are up and around us, you know, to pull ourselves off the bottom of the table. And, you know, I think we have to go in the weekend, throw everything at it. There's no excuses. We need the points, and we're going to be taking them.
Assisted by number 18, Robert Pereira. That's goal number 4 for the Phantoms, scored by 51, assisted by 18. We have the goal time of 3-0-4-9. Goal number 5 for the Peterborough Phantoms, score by 51, Eric Pfeiffer, assisted by the 93, Jarek Lachewski, and 24, Declan Long. Penalties for Telford Tigers, number 17, Aaron Bennett, receives a 2+10 for a check from behind, and also receives a 10-minute in-Simon penalty. Penalties on time at 37 minutes and 55 seconds. Goal number 6 for the Peterborough Phantoms, scored by number 17, James Farrar, assisted by number 16, Marcel Pepper, and 93, Aaron Fireschesky.
Earlier on today, we caught up with Tigers kit manager Andy Phillips to find out a little bit more about what his job entails.
The setup that we've got now is far more professional than in any other season. We've got more professional players with greater demands. So my job as equipment manager has grown this year. As you can see, I'm sharpening the skates. So I procure all of the equipment, all of the new guys we brought in. I've had to get equipment in at the 11th hour for all of those to come. And pretty much everything that you see around you, I do to make sure the guys get on the ice and can perform every week, week in, week out.
And we know you come to training and obviously you were involved in setting the trust up as one of the founder members and stuff. With all the changes, the new ownership and stuff, how are you kind of looking towards the future?
Well, when we set the trust up, we'd always hoped that a day like today would come. We'd hoped that it would be under the trust and the trust actually achieving the goal itself. It's probably come quicker than we'd anticipated. Wayne Scholes and Red Touch have come in and they're doing a fantastic thing for hockey in Telford. And the changes, as you can see, are quite overwhelming. If we'd continued as a trust-owned team, we would have struggled with equipment this year, as we have done in any other season. And with Wayne coming in and the resources that are now available, we can bring equipment in for the guys. We've got every player on sticks this year. We've been bringing in helmets. We can get jerseys quickly. We brought skates in for the guys. And these are all things that we've never been able to do as a trust previously.
Thank you. Some disappointing result and performance. I know you kept the guys in the change room for quite a while longer than normal, maybe. Can you tell us a little bit about what was said?
The fact that our top line were minus four over two periods. Guys having some responsibility when they don't have the puck. Guys having responsibility in the defensive zone. And it's dead easy always to look at the defence and the goaltender, but there's too many guys in there playing way too loose. There's no spine, there's no strength on them. You know, you go in, you make a hit for a purpose. It's not to try and obviously physically hurt anybody. It's make a hit so you stay on the inside path of the play. And too many times we didn't make our hits. We got beat back up ice. We weren't on the defensive side of the puck. And when you break into the scoring areas like guys did with no guys pressuring or taking sticks away and time, they're going to put the puck in the net. You know, our first period we had a lot of chances, we didn't take our chances, and ultimately when you don't, you take your chances, you find yourself behind the eight ball, and that's exactly what happened. I'm embarrassed. I was absolutely livid with the players. I still am. I think some are going to learn that there will be consequences for poor performance, and how we deliver that. You know, we've got to sit away and think about it. We've got to analyse what's just happened a little bit, and we've just spent 10-15 minutes with the other coaches. So, you know, have some structure in our game, have some responsibility in your own performance, and you know the old sayings go, from good defence will come good offence. Well, I think right now we've got guys with the mentality of good offence wins hockey games, it doesn't. And I've played on too many championship winning teams, too many teams that win hockey games by playing solid defensively. And if guys can't buy into that, then you know that's a sad situation, because it'll not be around very long.
And just looking forward to tomorrow, how do you kind of pick the guys up, or is it their responsibility after a performance like that they need to motivate themselves?
Ultimately, I think players have got to be motivated, but I still think there's a high level of responsibility that goes onto the coaching team, that you know you have to pick guys up. Everybody's different mentality. As a professional player, you have a level of performance and a level of execution that you have to meet every game. Yeah, you're going to have bad games, but to not give the effort, not give the passion and commitment for your teammates is ultimately their responsibility. I'll motivate the guys. I'll send a rocket. I'll send a message into the dressing room in the morning, as we've just done tonight, and they have to respond. But if they can't respond to those messages, then, like I said, they'll be looking for new jobs.
We knew they were there for the taking, and we just didn't come out to play in the first period, simple as that. You can't do that, and we talked about it before, and we said that, you know, every game's tough for us, and if we want to win, then we can't afford to come in after the first. Two down, three down, whatever it was, we can't afford to do that. And the second was more of the same. Just wasn't good enough. And I think it went all the way through, from our goalie to myself, to Timo, to, you know, James Pease. Everybody in the team didn't play good enough. And that's, for us, that's not good enough to win.
And then kind of moving on to tomorrow, how do you guys, you know, kind of individually, how do you pick yourselves up, and then as a team regroup and go again tomorrow and improve the performance and hopefully the result?
Well, you've got to take a look in the mirror. You've got to you know, go home and think about, you know, where you went wrong in the game. You know, to be fair, the third period we were a bit better, and we won 2-0 in the third period. So that's something to take into tomorrow. Give us a little bit of confidence. But at the end of the day, we've got to go home and realise our mistakes. but also not get too down about it. I mean, we have to lift our heads. You know, there's no point in coming into tomorrow's game with our heads down. You know, we have to come in with a positive attitude. You know, we'll go home, think about it tonight, and then tomorrow is a new day. So we come home and think about it, and then we come away, and then, you know, we get things in order and get back out again.
So a disappointing home result here for the Telford Tigers, and coach Tom Watkins not pulling any punches in his comments after the game. Join us again next Saturday as Telford Tigers looks to get back to winning ways when they take on the Guildford Flames.